Hi, I'm Chris Wolf, the host of Intermezzo on Classic 107, and this week I am looking at the wonderful recording legacy that Jascha Heifetz has recorded. As a musician, you can't help but come across the name Heifetz, and then when you hear him, you understand why, because he's just such a phenomenal player. And if you ask most professional violinists who their inspirations are, more often than not, the name Heifetz comes out of their mouth first. He's just a phenomenal violinist, great intonation, great sound, great warmth through his playing, and great virtuosic playing. He was a violinist who could literally do anything on the instrument. It's really amazing. Some of, you know, the interesting stories about Heifetz, he had a great work ethic. You know, there's the great saying, you know, if I don't practice one day, I notice it. If I don't practice for 2 days, the critics notice it. And if I don't practice for 3 days, the audience knows it. So he, you know, had a great devotion to his craft and his art. And he was also a great environmentalist, even, you know, long before the environmental movement really gained steam. In the, you know, 20s and 30s, he lobbied for clean air in Los Angeles and New York, and even some of his violin students helped him in this cause. So he was sort of, I guess, one of the first environmentalists around. And he was just a great human being. He enjoyed playing for the American troops during the Second World War, and was a great lover of the United States. You know, he immigrated to the States in 1925, and he adopted the new country with full fervor, commissioning works from composers for him to play, and just supporting American troops during the Second World War. So yeah, just an admirable individual. One of the violinists that's around today that really reminds me of Heifetz is James Ennis. The perfect intonation, the great virtuosic playing, and like I say, Jimmy's got a great warmth through his playing that it doesn't sound like it came out of a cardboard box like so many recording violinists do today. I mean, with Heifetz, I can always tell a Heifetz recording, and same thing with Jimmy. I mean, if I hear a James Ennis recording, I can pretty well tell it's a Jimmy Ennis recording. So, yeah. He died in 87, so it's, what, 28 years ago now, and I just want his legacy to continue, and just for newer audiences to classical music to appreciate the great violin playing that is Jascha Heifetz. Yeah, I still think to this day nobody comes close. I mean, he's just this not only the 20th century's great violinist into the 21st century, and there's nobody who can compare. Yeah.